Hey, this is Copenhagen and this is Tivoli. We're here in the Tivoli Gardens theme park. It's actually many years since I was here last. So we're gonna check it out and see if anything has changed or if it's the same old thing as always. So let's go and check this place out. So this place is definitely, most definitely rigged. That's what I think. So we're right under the main roller coaster. Or actually not the main roller coaster. The main roller coaster is the mountain coaster, the old one. It's like over 100 years old. But this is the Chinese type themed roller coaster. It's Demeonan, the demon. So the park is not heavily themed, but there is something. You can see little Chinese inspired buildings. There's a little store over here. I'm not gonna go into it and check it out in detail. We can see some things that they have here. I mean, it's stuff you can bring to your home and put in your garden. It's not very cheap though. Let's just have a little peek inside. So here they're playing music. So here we have some kind of ride. I don't really like the tall attractions. I like roller coasters and yeah, things like that. But not this. Pure terror. Here we have a classic attraction for this park. It's the flying carpet. Or actually it says monsunen, but it used to be the flying carpet. I've been on this many, many times. So they have a mix of thrilling attractions, or thrilling rides, and less thrilling rides. And everything is kind of dense, compact, everything is small here. So you can be together. The adults can go on thrilling rides while the children go on smaller rides next to the thrilling rides. And then they have like little games. And they have, and there we have the demon roller coaster again. Here we have a little cafe. So, I've eaten over there and it was really nice. It's actually, I think it's my favorite place in the entire park. It's a very, I don't know, cozy place. Oh, it's dusty here. People are dragging their feet. It's too hard for them to lift their feet. And outside this little park area of the park is the central parts of Copenhagen. Nice restaurant. Here's a ship. So, in the pirate ship, there, at least there used to be a restaurant. Maybe it's not anymore. But there are restaurants all over the place. Not so many stores, but many restaurants. Here we have a kiddie area. You can buy fish food and feed the hungry fish. So this is the little kiddie area. This is for the smallest children. They can run around and run around. So this is a bicycling attraction. It's really, really boring, but it's fun for the kids. Here we have a garden area. Let's have a look at the menu. It's a very quick look, so you have to pause it. Some Swedish tourists are standing behind me, and oh, they were so bothered by my camera. You know. And then they looked for a second at the sign, and then they went away. There are some quite calm and cozy places to eat. Ooh. So here we have like a, this is like a Chinese theater, an old theater. And over there is the main entrance. Let's look here. So that's the guy that founded the Tivoli Gardens park. Over here is like a store, like a, yeah, it's a store. So this is Ilum. It's yeah, it's kind of fancy. Danish designs, everything. Or not everything, but most of the things. So yeah, it's a little bit odd. I think these are themed to the park. It's a little bit odd to see this in a theme park, but here we have a gummy bear. And if you didn't know it, Denmark is quite famous for its design stuff. I'm whispering here. Now this was too fancy for me. Let's move on. I just noticed something. Can you see the lawnmower? It's a little rabbit and it has its own little castle. So here in the park they have like a real stage where they have real concerts. And the concerts, they're sometimes it's international known artists. So yeah. A lot of people here today. No wonder. It's a beautiful summer day. So this is a perfect day to be in a park in Scandinavia. The only bad thing is that there's people everywhere. So this roller coaster here, the oldest roller coaster in the world, that mountain building. And this is a little flume ride. So now I'm enjoying a yuzu drink. I think it's yuzu fruit tea with blueberry boba. It was 55 Danish kroner. Kiddie ride section. So this is a candy store. It's like old-fashioned candy. So this big jar is 500. That's like about $60, maybe 65 even. Liqueur. I would like to try the salt caramel or salty licorice. Looks good. Like licorice sticks. So take four, pay for three of these bags. There's a smell of licorice in this store, and it's actually pretty good. If you're Scandinavian, you like licorice. Not all of the time. Not everybody from Scandinavia likes licorice, but a lot of people do. There's still plenty of people. So I'm looking for a place to eat. Really, really hungry. And there are many places to eat, but the cheaper ones with burgers and fries and you know, the normal theme park food is really terrible here. So I'm gonna try to avoid that. Here's a Ben and Jerry's. So, having a little look here. Have a look at this. It's a really nice place.
You can fly to Gothenburg, Malmö, maybe Hamburg.
So here we have the big stage where they sometimes have concerts. So yeah, plenty of places to enjoy a good meal, but it's very expensive. Copenhagen is one of the most expensive cities in the world, and it's also it's also one of the nicest cities in the world. There's a special feeling that you get when you're here. You can really feel it, but if you have a small wallet with a small content, don't come to Tivoli, because this place is pretty expensive. Pretty nice. So this is like a food court type of place. And they have different types of food around. Not so many seatings. But it seems like pretty nice food. It's not like, it's not the typical theme park food, you know? Even though it's, I mean, it's expensive, but it's not like overly expensive. So you can enter this place from the street, and you get a stamp if you come from the theme park. I'm not gonna go through it in detail, I'm just having a look, so that we can get the feel of it.
Oh yeah.
So, if you're in a big company and everybody has different tastes, then you can come here, because you can get many different types of food, and it's all in the theme park. Different stuff, kung fu. Yeah, great food place. So here's my food. It's like a ramen with duck, elderflower lime drink. Here's more food. I don't know what that is. And Patricia is having a hot dog. And Tony is having chicken tenders. Yeah. So this is our dinner. We're awaiting some beef tartare as well. But that will come later. And here is more food.
Okay.
So this is it's like a little entertainment street, like a pleasure district or gambling district. Here is a indoor playground over here. It's closed. Yeah, that's the backside of the roller coaster. Let's go back. Here's some gambling. You can like slot machines and stuff. They have some pubs. This one seems to be closed. So there are the different pubs and beer places. Here's a beer garden. Not many people around now. It was quite packed before. So come at night or in the evening and you'll have a superb time. I mean, you need like 2 or 3 hours to do the main attractions, main rides. And then you can just enjoy a meal, have a drink or so. By the way, they closed the pirate ride. So our go was the last for the day. So let's go into this little, I think the store's called the Tivoli. Christmas ornaments. One of these cars is 59 Danish. Let's move on. So it seems like most of the rides have done their job for the day. So I think we're heading towards the exit. I'm just having a little quick look at the park and what it looks like in the dark. The park has a very nostalgic look. Let's see. Oh, we're gonna go for one last ride on the demon. And there's almost no way at all. Just a tiny little wait. No problemo. So, I just got off the demon roller coaster. It was pretty fun, and it was the last ride for the night. So now we're heading to the exit of the park. Yeah. Nice places. Oh, I wish they had. I wish it was open a little bit longer, like an hour or so. I always thought theme parks look amazing in the dark, especially well-themed theme parks. The theme of this park, I guess, is Tivoli. Tivoli has a special look and a special feeling. They're not trying to be Disney, they're not trying to be Universal. Actually, Disney is trying to be, or was trying to be, Tivoli. Not trying, but they kind of got some inspiration from it. This is one of the oldest parks in the world. So we're heading to the main entrance. Let's have a look here. The main entrance is over there. Let's just have a look at this. So, thank you for today, Tivoli.